Hi viewers, welcome to Crazy for DB. My name is Prashant. Today I bring you this video on SQL decode and case functions used in Oracle and other databases. We will find out what they are used for and also difference between them. You may then be able to know when to use what. But before we start on the main topic, I suggest you to watch this video until end so that you may answer the interview questions on this topic asked in various Fortune companies, which I have posted in the description box of this video. Please also spare a moment while you watch this video to subscribe with a click on bell icon and click the like button also. Now we turn to the subject. Actually, decode and case both are implementation of if, then and else like control structure in SQL. The SQL being a non-procedural language did not have this kind of conditional implementation initially. But Oracle had pioneered it by introducing the decode. The other SQL based databases lacked it for quite a long time. Then Munshi introduced case in SQL 2008 revision and made it available to all the SQL databases. However, except the similarity that both implement conditional control, there is vast difference between the two, and that we need to understand through examples. First, let us see the general forms of both and understand them what they are equivalent to. So here you can see the general form of decode. So decode, there is a bracket, then expression, the angle brackets only indicate that this is substitution. Angle brackets are not part of syntax. Then V1, R1, V2, R2, so there are V and R pairs like that. And then in the square bracket, this last part is D. Actually, this translates to, if this would have been a programming language, then if expression equals to V1, then return R1. Else if expression equals to V2, then return R2. So as to continue, else if expression equals to Vn, then return N, and that is the else part, that is D, else return D, and that is end if. If this would have been a programming language, then probably the structure could have been this, and so that is the translation of the decode and the explanation of the decode. As far as case is concerned, case takes this normal form. When condition 1, then return R1, when condition 2, then return R2, when condition N, return Rn, and again that part in the square bracket, that is optional, else part, return D if none of these conditions actually exist, and then you have to use the keyword end. So these are the implementations, or these are the explanations of the decode and the case. Now let us these two functions in action to solve example of granting increment to employees. This problem is quite simple. We move on to the Oracle to solve that problem. As ever, we are using again the EMP table, and we are using particularly decode and case as applicable to this cell column. Now this is the problem, very simple problem we are taking at the outset. For managers, we want to grant the increment of 300. For analysts, we want to grant the increment of 200. And for clerks, we want to grant the increment of 100. And for employees working in other jobs are not eligible for any increment. And if we write this statement, then select I will just make a copy. Yeah, sorry, this is not the one that we are referring. yeah, this is the problem. This is the solution to the problem. Manager, we wanted to give the increment 300, then analyst 200, and then clerk 100. And that is no increment to the employees working in the other job. So explanation is that job is the expression, and manager 300, this is V1-R1 pair, analyst 200, this is V2-R2 pair, clerk 100, this is V3-R3 pair, and 0 is that D, select ename, job, comma, sal, then sal plus decode, so whatever will be returned from here, and we call that increment salary as new sal from EMP. And so here is the execution. As you can see that, see, clerk is getting the increment of 100, then salesman is not getting any increment here. Managers are getting the increment of 300, and analysts are getting the increment of 200, as you can see over here. So that is our solution. Solution in terms of the decode function. Now the same problem we can see can be solved by using the case. So this is the case example. I will just copy the code to save time. Yeah, and so again, case syntax is there. Case when everything else is same. Case when job equals to manager, then 300. There is no comma. We have to just write the next case over there. When job equals to analyst, then 200. When job equals to clerk, then 100. Else 0, and that keyword end is there. Again, there is a alias that I'm using for you know, for the incremented salary as new cell, and from EMP with the semicolon, the statement ends over there. We will see the execution, and you will see that the answer is same as above, and this clerk was getting 100 over here, so same, the clerk is getting 100 over here in case of case also, and likewise you can verify that everybody according to this query is getting the increment. So that is the example of the basic use of case and the decode. Now, to understand the difference, let us come back to this page. Here I have given the difference in the tabular form. So there is a difference made out between decode and case. The first difference, you can see that Oracle, decode is the Oracle's proprietary function, whereas case is ANSI SQL compliant. Actually, as I said that for a long time, if then else implementation was not there in the SQL. It was for the first time introduced in the form of decode by Oracle. Hence, it then was termed as non-standard function. But later on, to introduce a same functionality or similar functionality, ANSI actually brought the case in its 2008 version. And so it is said to be ANSI compliant, and hence it is available across all the SQL based databases, including the Oracle. Then you can go to the second difference over there. In the second difference, as pointed out, decode has a serious limitation of not being able to use any logical comparison operator. Equality is built-in operator. No other operator can be used. Whereas in case of case, you can write fully searchable expressions with logical or comparison operator. So this is actually a very big difference between the two. As we have seen actually in case of decode, this expression is getting compared with v1, v2, v3 always with equality operator here. So actually we'll see that equality is the built-in part of the decode. That is what actually this second point says, whereas we can use fully searchable. Like here you can specify a condition in the form of a searchable expression, and that is the flexibility given to us by the case. That is what exactly it says. Now we will solve one problem over here, a bit complex problem. Here is that problem. Write a query to estimate incremented salary if employees currently getting salary say up to 1500 are eligible for increment of 300. Then above 1500 to 2450 are eligible for increment of 200. Then for employees currently getting above 2450, that should be 2451. Above 2450 up to 3000 are eligible for increment of 100, and then for the employees currently getting salary above 3000 are not eligible for an increment. So here we are actually talking about the ranges, and to solve this problem with the decode, actually we need to take the support of one another function called as sign. Sign basically is used for returning the sign of an arithmetic expression as 1, minus 1 or 0 for respectively plus, minus 1 and 0 sign of the output. And so the expression becomes quite complex in this case, and you are required to use the nested decode in this case. We will go to the Oracle to demonstrate the solution of this problem with the decode. Yeah, so this is the SQL code for the solution to this problem, and what we are doing here is select ename comma sal plus decode sign sal minus 3000, and here I am giving the option 1, that is v1. So if this is only possible when sign sal minus 3000 is 1, that is positive. So when sal is greater than 3000, then only this subtraction will produce a positive sign, and then salary will be greater than 3000, and as our problem says, the increment should be 0. Then of course this is going to the default of this first decode. We are applying second decode over here. Then we are saying again sign sal minus 2450 again 1. So what does it mean? That sal is greater than 2450, then only this one is possible, that is positive sign is possible, and in that case the salary will be above 2450 but below 3000 or up to 3000. The increment is 100 as our problem says. Then again the next case is default, where it will go beyond below 2450, and so this third decode we are applying in the default section of this previous decode, sign sal minus 1500, as you can see over here, again 1, that is salary above 1500, so that is in the range of 1500 to 2450, where the increment is 200 as our problem says, and then 300 is the default for all the remaining cases, that is salary below 1500. Again that has been given an alias as new sal from EMP. So that is the statement, and if I execute it, you will see that this is the result. As you can see, 800 is below 1500, so is getting the increment of 300 over here. Then 1600 is above 1500, is getting the increment of 200, and then 2450 and above, you are getting like 2850, you are getting the increment of 100 as said in the problem, and that 5000 is above 3000, and so he is not getting any increment. So thus we have solved the problem. The same problem can be solved very easily actually using the case statement, because case can use easy to search expressions using any sort of operators. And so we can again copy the code. So as you can see that we are writing very simple expressions. We don't try to use like nesting, etc., and take the support of sign, etc., as we have done in the decode case, decode function. Now the case, we can simply write when sal less than equals to 1500, then 3300, then when sal less than equals to 2450, then 200, then when sal less than equals to 3000, then 100. And so this is very easy to understand searchable expression that we can use in case of case. For all the remaining cases, else 0, and that is the end of the case as a new cell. And again, if I execute this, you can see that the solution is the same as over here. These two solutions are same because the problem was same. So you can see that Decode has actually simplified the case in many ways. Now there is one more important and more important difference between the decode and case. You can see that in case of decode, the expression is scalar. Now, what does it mean? Expression is scalar means that one expression is common with all the conditions. As we have seen in the one of the previous examples, I will take you to Oracle to show you that example. Actually, the first example here, maybe on the top. Yeah. So we have actually this job, that is the common expression to be compared with values like manager, analyst, and clerk, and all of them for equality. So there is only one expression job. So this is actually called as scalar expression, and the expression is scalar in case of decode. Whereas in case of case, it can work with varied predicates and searchable queries. So here we actually take one problem to solve this by case, which actually needs you to use varied predicates and searchable expressions. This problem could not have been solved with the help of decode. The problem is write a query to estimate incremented salary if there are four conditions given over there. Employee is currently getting 1000, then increment is 100. This is one condition. And then this is totally a different condition. Employee is getting commission, that is if they are eligible for commission, that is if their commission is not null, then the increment has to be 200. And then third is again totally different condition, where it says if the job of the employee is manager, then they are eligible for increment of 300. And for all the other cases, there is no increment, as is said in the fourth condition. We will see this problem solved with the as you can see, we come to this code, and so these conditions have been applied. Case when sal less than equals to 1000, then 100, that was our first condition, as I read out the problem to you. When com is not null, that is when the employee is eligible for commission, then we wanted to give the increment of 200. When job equals to manager, then the increment. So you can see that overall there are three different conditions and three different increments that we want to grant in those respective conditions, and that is not possible with the decode, but is possible with the case. So we will execute this query, and you see that yes, so when the salary is less than 1000, that is here the salary is 800, you can see that there is increment of 100. This Alan has got the commission 300, and for all those who get the commission, they are eligible for the increment of 200. So his earlier salary was 1600 and now it is 1800, so the increment of 200 has been granted. And you see that the manager, Jones is the manager, and you see that for manager we wanted to give the increment of 300, and so this is earlier salary is 2975, now it is 3275, that is the increment of 300. And for all the other cases, for example, like in case of clerk, Adams, his salary is not less than 1000, neither he is manager nor he is getting commission, and so you see that his salary remains as before, and so no increment has been granted. So that is how actually we have solved this problem with the case which we could not have solved using the decode. Now let us talk about the last difference, and this last difference says that decode can be used only in SQL. Yes, you can use the decode only in the SQL statements. What does that mean is that if you are writing a code, PLSQL code, then you cannot use decode as a general function. You cannot call this decode as a general function. Of course, if the SQL also contains SQL, PLSQL also contains SQL, then you can use the decode in that SQL, but not directly call the decode in the PLSQL. Whereas case is available in both the environments, that is, it can be called in PLSQL blocks as well as in the SQL statements. So friends, I hope you must have understood the difference between the decode and the case. Visit the description box for relevant interview questions. If you have any questions or doubts, put them in the comment section. Be assured to get the reply. Subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching.